One of my major legacy goals is to make prevention, world-class prevention, available to a lot more folks. So far, world-class prevention has only been available to world-class wealthy. Just a few years ago, a Bale Doneen type of evaluation cost about $5,000. And still, in a lot of places, you can get those. They cost more like $15,000. $20,000, $25,000. There are some places in California, LA, that charge that for their own basic preventive evaluation. Now, again, my goal is to make it available to people that that can't afford that. Now, obviously, putting this information on for free on YouTube is a major step in that direction, but the one thing that you can't do on free public videos like YouTube is discuss patients' results. So what the idea here is to provide the lion's share of what takes time for the patient for free, that is through YouTube, through the videos, and then get to the point to where an educated patient can then access his or her own labs, his or her on CIMT, and then access me or another qualified prevention specialist to find out exactly what's going on with their health and develop a plan and next steps for improving that health and preventing disability. Now, that's not a simple process, but it's, again, it's my legacy goal. This is going to be a series on, well, I think we'll call it a personal prevention series, and it's going to be basically going through the steps that you would go through if you had a typical Bale Doneen type of evaluation with me and with a lot of other folks. So without any further discussion on that, we'll start off with personal prevention part one. So the basic agenda when we meet with a patient is to go over the history, look at their meds, their lifestyle is critical. And again, these evaluations in the past took up to 4.5 hours and multiple visits. The more the patient knows, the more we can get very efficient with the patient's time and with ours as well. We go into prevention basics and discussion of the patient's results. Then we talk about recommendations, plans, and next steps. Now, I'll be using a lot of slides from Bale Doneen. You can see some of that down in the corner. When Brad was in our practice, we adopted a lot of his basic slide presentation. This includes a lot of his basic information, but again, it includes a lot more. So we focus on history, lifestyle, medications, and then we start talking about what's medicine without prevention. It's sort of like waiting until the tsunami hits and hoping you can clean up the mess, or waiting until the motorcycle wreck and trying to clean up the mess after somebody's already paralyzed. It just doesn't work as well. We talk a little bit about how often this is happening with heart attack. We'll go over that in just a minute. Stroke, anybody know what FAST means? Why do you need to know what FAST means? Face, arm, speech, and time. Because stroke is the number one disabler in this country. If after people begin to work with me, they first come to me saying, I want to avoid a heart attack. After they continue to work with me, they say, you know what? As I age, I'm becoming less and less concerned about a heart attack and much more concerned about a stroke because I really don't want to be disabled for 20 years before I die. Now, to the credit of the cardiologists, the invasive cardiologists, the cardiothoracic surgeons, they are one of two specialties that have actually increased the expected lifespan. They did it by a few months. Now, the other specialty is my guys, are my guys, the preventive guys. But before I try to take too much credit, it's really not the docs. I mean, the preventive docs have had a huge impact, but it's really more engineers, like water engineers, getting clean water. And if you're not aware of the impact of hygiene and things like water on lifespan, go back and see some of my videos on cholera. Historical issue, but again, very much a thing that added years to our expected lifespan. Now, back to the cardiologist, they added a few months, and here's how they did it. So that's another point. They didn't add a whole lot to the lifespan, and the way they added it was by doing things to people that you really don't want to have done. How often are heart attacks happening? Well, every 34 seconds, someone has a heart attack. About, I think, half of those are lethal. So for about half of the people, they find out they have a heart attack by dying. I think David's number is very, very helpful to remember. He quotes that statistic about it takes 3 weeks in terms of heart attack and stroke for us to have the death equivalent of Vietnam War. That took decades. It took a long time. It took a lot of years. So you may say, well, you know, the Vietnam War was young people. This is old people. That's part of the problem. We have an expectation that it's natural to die in your 60s, 50s, even 40s, but clearly in your 60s from heart attack and stroke. It doesn't have to be. That, again, is the point. Another point that we need to reconfigure is for women, for example, and our focus on cancer. Women are very much afraid of breast cancer. Well, women are 10 times more likely to die from cardiovascular disease than breast cancer. I agree, both of them are devastating. Breast cancer is devastating, but as we said, being wheelchair bound for 20 years from a stroke or heart failure is also devastating. Now, regarding strokes, a quarter of them are repeat occurrences. Every 4 minutes, someone dies from a stroke. So from that perspective, what is that? That's a Vietnam War every, 2 to 3 months? So, as I've discussed, I got a lot of these original slides originally from Brad and Amy. And if you go to a Bale Doneen provider, I would, again, it's some of the best prevention that's available in America these days. You'll see a lot of these slides. You'll see a lot of focus on the details of prevention. And in fact, what I'd like to do for a second is talk a little bit about what's different between Bale Doneen and other preventive practices, as well as non-prevention. So we've talked about non-prevention for a while. It's basically waiting till a disease happens and trying to cure it, which doesn't work for the big killers, the big disablers. I won't go so much into that, but I'll draw some comparison between basic prevention programs and a Bale Doneen. So with a basic prevention program, they'll quote you statistics like Framingham statistics and say, look, you need to lose weight. You need to keep salt down. That's been shown to decrease hypertension. You need to maybe take a statin if you have these characteristics. Well, people don't like that. And it's very, very difficult to do a lot of the things that you need to do to prevent heart attack and stroke, like lose weight. Because you can't just stop eating, you have to eat. But, so then that's the question, you need to decrease. And so you need to, in order to motivate yourself on a regular basis, you need to know more than just that there are risks that people have shown out there. You need to know what's going on with you. And that's the difference between a Bale Doneen prevention activity and something like a basic prevention activity that you might get at the YMCA. With Bale Doneen, they go into details or we go into details of major focus on what's going on with your metabolism and how that's being impacted. Lots of labs. Now, one other distinction, at this point, there's some differences in what I do versus a typical Bale Doneen as well. With Bale Doneen, you get, again, a lot of focus on cardiovascular inflammation, a little bit of focus on the major causes, the major cause being insulin resistance. With me, you get a much bigger focus on the root cause, especially insulin resistance, how that interacts with other causes like Lp(a), familial hypercholesterolemia, and things like that. So we go much deeper into your metabolism and how to change that metabolism to keep you from gaining that middle age spread and the inflammation, the plaque that happens as you get older. there's been some good research with the Bale Doneen program itself in terms of helping people get healthier. And that's just a couple of slides on that. Now I'm going to finish up this video with a comment. Here's the thing. Where does cardiovascular inflammation, where does plaque have an impact? Well, it's only the places where you have arteries. Like your brain, your eyes, your eyeballs, your heart, your kidneys, men's erectile function, the arteries that supply your legs, so your ability to walk. In other words, everywhere. And this is not just a heart-related issue. Cardiovascular inflammation and its major cause, insulin resistance, impact all of our body parts, have a huge impact, and change our lifestyle dramatically. So again, if you've made it this far, I appreciate your interest as I typically stumble around on some of the concepts, trying to get them right, trying to help you understand what you need to do to prevent your own heart attack, stroke, disability. Thanks, and if you hit that subscribe or like button, it makes a big difference. An even bigger difference happens when you share. You can share on Facebook, Instagram, LinkedIn, Twitter, Pinterest. When you do that, it makes a big difference in terms of the algorithm. It sends this to other people, realizing that humans think this is interesting information and helpful. Thank you again.